Please welcome Mr. Michiel Hagenaars, working for the City of Ghent Economic Service, that will then be joined by Mr. Wim Verstock, Director of Ray Consult.
Yeah, good afternoon, everybody. First, I will give you some brief introduction of the City of Ghent with some data and key figures. And later on, Wim Verstock will explain what the loop is about. So first, Ghent. It has a very strategic location internationally, but also within Belgium. We are like on the crossway of the motorways towards Brussels and Antwerp. And also our key figures are in our benefits, because there are 240,000 inhabitants and there's like an expected growth of 15,000 people within the next 10 years. We also have like a very young society, because there are like a lot of influence of the students which are like studying in Ghent. Our direct market is about 450,000 people, and our indirect market is about 1 million people. We have 2,600 stores, 1,450, we call it horeca, but it's like the bars and restaurants and so on, and 1,500 commercial services. To have a focus on the city center, there are like 570 stores within the city center, about 81,000 square meters, and we have like 275 bars and restaurants and so on. To give you an idea, the passers in the high streets, it's about 140,000 passers a week, and in the middle streets, there are about 75,000 passers. We have the largest pedestrian area in Belgium with about 35,000 square meters. The city of Ghent emphasizes that there has to be like a complementary between the city center and also all the developments in the periphery. The city of Ghent became like a co-owner in the development of the project, but I guess Wim Verstock will tell you more about that.
This site, as you can see on this slide, is in direct flight 4 kilometers from the old city center of Ghent. It's an old airfield that was for sports airplanes next to the city of Ghent. And it's situated along the E40, which is a highway that goes from Ostend going to Brussels. In 2008, we started the infrastructural works. Here, the public transport or the public transportation system has been made in advance. We're going to bring in a factory outlet center for which we already have a socio-economic permit. There are only a very small part of inline shops, and there is still 13,000 square meter of room for big box retail. Added to that, there is a possibility to develop a leisure project of 35,000 square meters with added restaurants. So total of leisure will be around 40,000 square meters. So I'm going to go very shortly through the project, starting at the -1 with an underground parking that will connect IKEA which will add more parkings for IKEA. Then on the ground floor, there will be more parkings because, as you see, there is a road going straight to the site. And to bridge this road, we are going to build on both sides parkings up to a level of 8 meters. And then a deck will be made on which the retail will be developed. Up on top of these big boxes, we will try to develop 40,000 square meter of leisure. And then in the end, it will be like layered like this. We will have different layers in the project and, of course, different destinations.
Please welcome Mr. John Forkin, Managing Director of Marketing Derby.
First of all, where are we? We're a central city. We're in the UK. We are 90 minutes north of London. 6 million people live within the city within 1 hour of the city centre of Derby. We're also a business city, and we are a high technology city. What that means for retailers is good news, because it means that Derby now has the highest average salaries of any city outside of London. The retail catchment area for Derby is around 850,000 people. The offers, if you like, in terms of retail opportunities, I'd split into two or three. First of all is the major shopping mall itself, which is Westfield, and this shopping centre now attracts 26 million visitors every year. Contrasting, if you like, the modern 21st century mall is the Cathedral Quarter, an area which is quintessentially English, the 18th century heart of the city. It's home to UNESCO World Heritage Site, and it's also home to lots of premium independent retailers. Within the Cathedral Quarter, you have a new retail scheme, a £20 million mixed development scheme, which has a number of opportunities for retailers in, as you can see there, in a historic fabric. And then contrasting that, contrasting the cathedral quarter, we have the River Lights development, a modern 21st century development which has just been completed at the moment. It's right by the city's River Derwent, and there are a number of opportunities for retailers, particularly in the food, drink and leisure sector within that scheme. The numbers are reasonably impressive for that scheme because at the bottom of that drawing you can probably see the zigzag. That's the city's main bus station. So that attracts 12 million passengers per year going through that particular site. It's across the road from the Westfield, which I've already mentioned has 26 million visitors, and it's within 5 minutes walk of 15 cinema screens and 4 theatres. So it's a very, very central location, right by the riverside, and a fantastic opportunity for leisure operators. So essentially, that's what I wanted to share with you today, is a city which is probably a best-kept secret, a city on the up with an awful lot of wealth in the community, and a city full of opportunity. So if you want to know more about Derby, talk to us or visit us. Thank you very much.